guys, welcome to my channel IT Support People. Today I'll show you how to create VLAN and how to do inter-VLAN routing and how to access internet from VLAN PCs using some dynamic and static routing both in Cisco router and Cisco layer 3 switch. Basically you'll find lots of YouTube video regarding VLAN, but this video is pretty much unique and different because you'll see in those videos they have used simulation tools or software like GNS3 and Packet Tracer, but in my videos I have used a real practical Cisco router and Cisco layer 3 switch. That's why you will have a real world scenario and practical experience. Secondly, I have shown some troubleshooting technique how to resolve those problems, so that's why you will have some real world troubleshooting technique. Please don't forget to subscribe my channel and press the bell icon so that you will be notified about the all latest video which I will create in future. So let's get started. Now I will show you the network topology for this network. Here you can see this is a ISP home router, and this one is a Cisco 2851 router, and this is a layer 3 Cisco switch, and the model is 3560 24 4 port switch. This ISP home router is DHCP enabled, and the LAN port of this home router is connected to gigabit 0/0 port of the Cisco router, where the network is 192.168.1.0, and the gigabit 0/1 in the gigabit 0/1 port of the Cisco router we will create a DHCP pool where the network will be 192.168.2.0, and in gigabit 0/1 port we will make this port as a default router where the IP would be 192.168.2.1, and this gigabit 0/1 connection from gigabit 0/1 port will go to the first Ethernet port of the switch. Basically, before creating any VLAN in the switch, all the ports belong to default VLAN 1. So in this video I'll briefly show this portion how to configure the Cisco router for accessing internet through ISP home router, because I have already created an a YouTube video how to configure Cisco router for accessing internet. The link I have already given in the description, or you can check on the top right corner. So basically I will focus in this video I will focus on switch part, how to create a VLAN. For example, next I have to I'll create a VLAN 10 and a VLAN 20, and I will assign IP to VLAN interface, and then I will connect one laptop to VLAN 10 and another desktop PC to VLAN 20. Similarly, I will put IP to laptop and desktop PC. Then I'll apply some I'll apply IP routing for inter VLAN routing, and then you know, this is a layer 3 managed switch. Like this switch, some layer 3 switch doesn't support NAT, because if you want to connect to internet you have to configure NAT. So for this this time we will apply some dynamic routing both in the switch and the router part for connecting internet. You can see that this is the Cisco router 2800 is router, and this is my switch, layer 3 switch, and you can see this connection is coming from the gigabit 0/1 port of this router, and this cable is connected to VLAN 10, and this connection goes to this laptop, and another connection is connected to VLAN 20, and this connection goes to the this desktop PC. Now I will go to PuTTY. This is PuTTY. I connected my laptop to Cisco router through console cable, so I'll enter the privilege mode enabled. As I said earlier that in this video I'll not describe step by step how to configure Cisco router for accessing internet, then the this video will be too long. So what I'll do in this router configuration part, I already saved the configuration command in a notepad. So what I'll do, I will load this configuration to the router so that we can make the video shorter. And I have already said that I have already made an YouTube video for describing step by step how to connect Cisco router and switch to ISP home router and accessing internet. You can check this video. Here everything is described thoroughly. So now I will load the configuration file. This configuration file. So now I will load this configuration file to the router. So first I have to select all, then Control C, copy. Then I have to enter enable mode. So I am in already in enable privilege mode. So just right click here, and you can see all the configuration is being loaded. Yeah. Okay, it's done. The configuration in router part is done. We can check the interface, like show IP interface brief. You can see the interface gigabit 0/0 and gigabit 0/1. So the configuration in router part is done for making the Cisco router accessible for internet through the ISP home router. Now I'll go to switch part. So now I have connected my laptop to the switch through console cable, and I will enter the switch privilege mode, enable, and I will check the interface of this switch, show IP interface brief. So yeah, here you can see there is an interface VLAN 1, so it's a managed switch, so it already So you can see the VLAN 1 already taken IP from the DHCP pool, here. So basically, before creating any VLAN, all the ports belong to VLAN 1, and you can see the VLAN 1 IP address is 192.168.2.2. Basically, we haven't done anything with the switch yet. So we'll check the VLAN. Show VLAN. So you can see there is only one VLAN, VLAN 1, and all the ports from first Ethernet 1 to 24 and gigabit Ethernet port all belongs to VLAN 1. If you see the summary, then we will create another VLAN, we will assign interface to VLAN, configure the switch port access, then we will assign IP to VLAN, and we will apply IP routing for inter VLAN routing, and next we will apply some dynamic and static routing. Let's do this. So first we will create a VLAN. So VLAN 10, we have to go configuration mode, global configuration mode, configuration terminal. So we'll create VLAN, VLAN 10. We have to you can see it enters the configuration VLAN. We have to give a name. So name is HR, and exit. We'll create another VLAN, VLAN 20. The name would be IT. Exit. Now I will assign interface to a particular VLAN. So before doing this, if you look at the picture, you can see that from first Ethernet 13 to first Ethernet 18, that will go for VLAN 10, and first Ethernet port 19 to 24 port, that those ports will go for VLAN 20. So interface interface range, because we are taking more than one interface, multiple interface, that's why interface range. So first Ethernet 0/13 to 18. So then we have to apply switch port mode access. SWI switch port mode access. We have to apply VLAN 10 for switch port mode access. SWI switch port access VLAN 10. VLAN 10. Then no shutdown. Then exit. Similarly, we have to do this for VLAN 20. So still I'm in global configuration mode. Interface range, first Ethernet 0/19 to 24, and switch port mode access, and switch port access VLAN 20, then exit. Now I have to assign IP address to particular VLAN. You know, for switch we cannot, like a router, we cannot assign IP to the switch port. We have to assign IP to the VLAN. So I will assign IP to VLAN 10 and 20 as well. So still I'm in global configuration mode. Interface VLAN 10. So as you can see that for VLAN 10, the IP would be 192.168.3.0 network. So I'll give the first IP 3.1. Okay. So IP address 192.168.3.1. The subnet mask 255.255.255.0 and exit. Similarly for VLAN 20, interface VLAN 20 and IP address, that would be 4.0. So IP address 192.168.4.1 and the default the subnet mask 255.255.255.0 and exit. If you check the VLAN configuration in the switch, so show exit, show VLAN, you can see that the VLAN 1 is now from 1 to 12, fast Ethernet port 1 to 12, and VLAN 10 HR, that is from fast Ethernet 13 to 18, and VLAN 20 IT, that is fast Ethernet 19 to 24, same like this diagram, 1 to 12 VLAN 1. This VLAN 2 10 and VLAN 20. If I check the IP interface brief, then show IP interface brief. Yeah, here you can see that VLAN 1 under the 192.168.2.2 and VLAN 10 3.1 and VLAN 20 is 4.1. Now I will assign IP to the laptop. So I will assign IP 192.168.3.2. Which is under the network this VLAN, and I will assign another IP to another desktop 4.2. Now I will assign this IP to the laptop. For doing this, right click here, open network and internet setting, browse to network and sharing center, change adapter setting, right click here, go properties, and IPv4, and we'll put IP address 192.168.3.2 and the subnet 255.255.255.0 and the default gateway would be the VLAN interface IP address, so 192.168.3.1. okay. Similarly we have to put IP address in the desktop PC. You can see that I already put IP 192.168.4.2 and the subnet mask and the default gateway 4.1. So if you check the command prompt ipconfig, here you can see that the IP address 4.2 and the gateway 4.1. Now for accessing VLAN 1 laptop to VLAN 10 laptop to VLAN 20 PC, I have to apply IP routing. So I'll go to switch portion, enable configuration mode. I have to apply IP routing for inter VLAN routing. IP routing. So now I will check the connectivity from VLAN 10 PC to VLAN 20 PC by doing ping. So I'll go to command prompt. I know the IP address of the VLAN 20 PC is PING ping 192.168.4.2. Yes, the ping is successful. Now I will check the connectivity from VLAN 20 network to VLAN 10 network. This is the desktop PC from VLAN 20. So I'll check the IP config. Yes, the network is the IPv4 address is 192.168.4.2. I'll ping the VLAN 10 laptop. The IP is 192.168.3.2. Yes, the ping is successful. So we can access from VLAN 20 PC to VLAN 10 PC. Now I will apply a static routing command in this switch. You know, before I configured this 192.168.2.1 port as a default router, so I will apply a static IP command in this switch to access the router. So I mean global configuration mode. So IP route 0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.0.168.2.1. We already check that VLAN 10 and VLAN 20 can access each other. Now we will check whether VLAN 1 can accessible from VLAN 10 and VLAN 20. So what I'll do, I'll change the laptop from VLAN 10 to VLAN 1. Then I'll try to ping from VLAN 1 to VLAN 20. Now I'm disconnecting this laptop from VLAN 10 and connecting it to VLAN 1. Okay. Now I'll change the Ethernet port configuration. You can see IPv4 take IP automatically. Okay. Yes, now I'll check the IP address, IP config. Yes, you can see that it's taking IP from the 192.168.2.3. So according to the picture, it's a 2.0 network. So now I will ping from VLAN 1 to VLAN 20. So PING ping 192.168.4.2. You can see that VLAN 20 PCIP is 4.2. So what's going on? No, it's not accessible from VLAN 1 to VLAN 4. Timeout. So VLAN 1 PC cannot access VLAN 4 or VLAN 3 PC. We'll fix it out. Now I'll check whether from VLAN 1 is it possible to check the is it possible to access the router or the ADSL ISP router or the internet. So let's do that. I'll check ping the Cisco router default gateway, Cisco router 192.168.2.1. yeah, it's successful. Then I'll ping the home router, ping 192.168.1.1. yes, is successful. And I'll ping the Google DNS server, ping 8.8.8.8. yes, that's successful. So from VLAN 1 we can access this router and the internet. Now I'll put back the laptop from VLAN 1 to VLAN 10. Now I again put back the laptop from VLAN 1 to VLAN 10. Now I check the IP again, IP config. You can see it's 192.168.3.2. And we'll check, we'll ping from this VLAN 10 PC to router, PING ping, Cisco router 192.168.2.1. Okay. No, it's not successful. We can't ping from VLAN 3 PC to Cisco router. It's timeout. We'll check. So as we cannot access the Cisco router, we'll not be able to access the ISP router and internet as well. So to fix this issue, we'll apply some dynamic routing in this switch so that the VLAN 10 and VLAN 20 network can access the router and ISP home router and internet by this neighbor 192.168.2.0 network. Now I will apply dynamic routing EIGRP both in the switch and the router part. For switch part, enable, go to global configuration mode, configuration terminal. The EIGRP command is you know Now I will apply EIGRP for 192.168.3.0 network and 192.168.4.0 network and 192.168.2.0 network, because for accessing internet 192.168.1.0, the neighbor of this router is 2.0 network. So we will apply EIGRP in the switch router EIGRP, and then the autonomous system number, for example 10. The condition of applying EIGRP, you have to follow, you have to meet three criteria: the same autonomous number, and the same subnet mask, and the same matrix value. So the next we'll define the network 192.168.3.0, the subnet mask 255.255.255.0. Similarly for the network 4.0 and the network 2.0. I'll also apply a dynamic EIGRP routing in the Cisco router part. So now I will enter the router privilege mode ENA enable, then global configuration mode, configuration terminal. Then I will apply dynamic EIGRP routing protocol, ROUT router EIGRP. Make sure the autonomous number must be same with the neighbor network, so it was 10. Then the network would be network 192.168.2.0, the subnet mask 255.255.255.0. Before applying the routing, I'll open the switch party. So I just apply the dynamic routing in the router part, enter. You can see that both sides they got the neighbor from router part, the neighbor 192.168.2.0, which was the interface IP of gigabit 0/1. They got the new neighbor adjacency, and here in the switch part you can see that they got the neighbor 192.168.2.1, the adjacency. And between this network and this VLAN network, the neighbor part is this 192.168.2.0 network, and the neighbor is the VLAN 1 interface, which is 192. If you look here, so that is 192.168.2.0, 2.2. So by applying this dynamic EIGRP routing protocol, this network and this network identify the neighbor dynamically. Enable show IP route. You can see that the network DMIS dynamic EIGRP routing. Here is the classification. So the network 192.168.4.0, which is connected to gigabit Ethernet 0/1 via the VLAN 1 interface IP address. So if you look at the picture, so this 4.0, this 4.0 network is connected to gigabit 0/1 interface via the VLAN 1 interface IP address. Similarly here, the network 192.168.3.0 is also connected to gigabit Ethernet 0/1 via the VLAN 1 interface IP address, and 1.0 directly connected to 0/0. That 1.0 network is connected to gigabit 0/0, and 2.0 is directly connected to 0/1. And this is the static IP routing we applied in the router port part for accessing the default gateway of the ISP router, ISP home router 192.168.1.1. This is the default gateway of ISP home router. So now I think from every VLAN we can access every VLAN, and I think now everything is fine. Let's check. So if we go to command prompt, now we are in VLAN 10. Check the IP config. IP config. Yes, we are in VLAN 10, 3.2 IP. We ping the Cisco router. PING ping 192.168.2.1. Yes, it is successful. We'll ping the ADSL home router. We'll ping the ADSL home router. The default gateway is 192.168.1.1. So ping 168.1.1. Yes, that is successful. Now we will ping the Google server. PING ping 8.8.8.8. Yes, that is also successful. Similarly, I'll check from this desktop PC the connectivity. So check the IP first. IP config. Yes, this is 192.168.4.2. Then we'll ping the Cisco router 192.168.2.1. Yes, the ping is successful. Then we'll ping the ISP home router 1.1. Yes, that is also successful. Then we'll ping the Google server as well. 8.8. Yes, that is also successful. We checked that connection from VLAN 20 PC to Google DNS server is successful. Now we will check the internet connection from VLAN 20 PC to, by browsing internet. So we'll go to Google Chrome and we'll go to YouTube. So it's not loading, something wrong. So what I'll do, I'll check the internet setting. I'll go to Network Sharing Center. Okay, advanced setting. Basically, we haven't provided any DNS information here. So we'll go to IPv4 setting. And we'll put the DNS, Google DNS server information here, 8.8.8.8. Yes, okay. So now we'll check it, check the YouTube reload. Yes, now it's coming. Now we'll check IT support people. Yes, IT support people. This is my YouTube channel. You can see if we play this video. Yes, it's running. So that's mean VLAN 20 PC is accessible. Can access internet. So similarly, like VLAN 20 desktop PC, we put Google DNS server IP here. Now let's browse internet from VLAN 20 PC. You go to YouTube. Type IT support people. Yes, this is my YouTube channel, IT support people. Yes, if we run this video. Yes. Yes. So VLAN 10 PC also accessing internet. So now we check that VLAN 10 PC is also accessible from internet. And so finally, we created VLAN and applied inter-VLAN routing. We access internet from VLAN laptops and VLAN desktops, VLAN 10 and VLAN 20 PCs. We access from VLAN 1 to VLAN 10 and VLAN 20. We ping VLAN, Cisco router, ADSL router, internet. So everything is done.
If you think this video is helpful, please don't forget to like and subscribe my channel. And you can let me know any queries through comments. Your little appreciation will inspire me to make the next video. Thanks for watching.